Gentle ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft. I hope you're having a good day today. And if you're not, you're doing it wrong. You should try again. Oh, press space to try again. Okay. Boop. I'm almost out of food again, and these potatoes are useless. Basically did nothing. So today I'm going to be working on a potion room. This is just temporary to keep mobs out. So I've decided to put the potion room here, and so I've been digging it out a bit. The end result will probably be quite a bit bigger than this, and I'm gonna want maybe a tall epic ceiling. I haven't really worked out the ceiling at all, so I'm not sure what I'm gonna want. But my initial plan was I wanted basically a window here. I wanted the room to be about this size, a window here, and maybe a balcony that you could walk out on. And I'm gonna try to do that still. I might put a window on this side if I can. But the end result that I came up with is the room is gonna be quite a bit longer this way. It doesn't necessarily have to be that way. I could probably make it smaller if I wanted to, but I think it looks good how I have it. I have it all built out in a creative world, somewhat, partially built. So I still kind of want a balcony here, but it's going to have to stick out. You know what I mean? It's going to be hanging over the edge here, which is fine. I could possibly terraform some of this mountain here so that it looks like it's sort of being supported. I'll try to do that the best I can. But I was thinking, since there will be some sort like a balcony sticking out, I might build a bridge from this side to over here. Because if you think about it, our potion room will need, we're going to need sugar, so it's convenient that that's there. But we're going to need lots of things from the farms, like melons, carrots, what else? I'll probably have to build a netherwort farm down there somewhere. So if we're going to be getting a lot of our ingredients from down on the farm, it's useful to maybe have a way to get over here. So I don't know if I should build a bridge, maybe work a way down in there, or just build some stairs that come down. You know what I mean? Maybe make a path just along here, and then we can just enter in from this way. So, I don't know. I'll have to think about it. And once I have a bit of work done on the potion room, I'll come back to you guys and we can check it out. I am getting all kinds of lag for some reason. If I look this way, it's okay. I think I'm at 60. There we go. There's something over here. I don't know what. There it is. Yep. Ooh, my computer doesn't like that. I don't have any major redstone contraptions, I don't think. Could it be farm animals, like, loading in? Bunch of chickens and, I mean, there's not really that many, if you think about it. And I've never had that problem before. Wow, I am getting so much lag right here. I'm gonna go somewhere else and see if I still get lag. Yeah, okay, so when I run from here all the way to here, it drops down to about 30. Yep, 30 frames a second. And that usually doesn't happen when I record. 60, 60. Huh, not as bad there. I'm gonna stop recording real quick and do some more testing. Nope, 30 again. Look at that. 30. Maybe I should reinstall the game, I don't know. I think I've had this issue before. Okay, so I just reinstalled Minecraft. Let's test this out. See if we get a big frame drop or anything. Nothing too major. 57, that's pretty normal, I guess, for recording. I'm recording at 1080p. At 30 frames per second, that's not too bad. Let's test it up here, see how this goes. Yeah, seems better. You know, it's actually pretty expensive to make all of these chests. You wouldn't think so, but each one of them costs 8 planks. Multiply that by 10 here, 5 there. Not to mention that I'm going to be putting 5 plus 5, so a total of 10 hoppers across here. And each one of those is 5 iron, and they require a chest for some reason. I really think that recipe should be changed, in my opinion. It doesn't make a lot of sense for a hopper to need a chest. It really only holds 5 items, when a chest can hold 27, so it's a little strange, a little tedious, but it is what it is. I'm actually going to... You know what I should do is really farm these jungle trees. That'll be a great source of wood. I might actually have some in a chest somewhere. But let me talk about a little bit of the design here, why I'm putting hoppers in chests here. So in Minecraft, there's a total of 13 potions, I believe, and 3 of them are harmful potions. I think. I might have to double check on that. There's a total of 10 major ingredients, though. And you get the 3 harmful potions with fermented spider eyes, I think. So there's like potion of harming, poison, and something else. And like I said, those each require fermented spider eyes. And if you take an awkward potion and make or add fermented spider eyes to it, I think that's a potion of night vision? I don't know. I have it all written down somewhere. But, yeah, I'm going to have, so rows of chests there, chests for each ingredient, and back here I'm going to have this access. I don't know how I'm going to get back here in the end, but I'm going to want to get back here, and I'll label all these up here too, so that when I'm filling all of these, I'll do it from back here. I'll have them labeled so I know what to put, what goes where, and I'm going to have signs probably here labeling this side as well. So once we get our ingredient, let's say, you know, whatever ingredient is in here, we'll take it. I'm going to have glass bottles. I'm going to have nether wart. What else did I put in here? Something that all potions will need. Oh, modifiers. So, okay, glass bottles, nether wart, redstone to make potions longer, and gunpowder to make splash potions, and what is it? What am I thinking of? Glowstone dust to make the second level of the potion. So I'm also gonna have chests up here and here, I think, and these will be for our final potions. Once we've made the potions that we want, we can just keep them all in a single double chest here and another one here. And I'm probably going to put brewing stands here. So, Yeah, there's still a lot of work to be done. And I don't know if you guys caught a few episodes ago, I mentioned that my recording hardware, like, it likes to do whatever it wants and shuts off when it wants, and I really don't know what's wrong with it. But it's making this episode challenging, not to mention that I had to reinstall Minecraft, and it's always a struggle, isn't it? There's gods out there, there's demons who don't want me to make Minecraft episodes. But anyways, I'm trying, so we'll see if I can get some more work done, and I'll come back to you guys soon. So I went through all of my chests looking for more iron, and I'm pretty much out, which kind of stinks. I haven't gone caving in quite a while. So I'm looking around for iron. I think I added it up. I need, let's see, I have 8 pieces plus 4, so 12. And I think I need a total of 40 pieces of iron. I think, because I need 8 more hoppers. They cost 5. 8 times 5 is 40, minus 12 that I have. So, yeah. 28 pieces of iron. Where am I going to find that? I feel like I've looked through just about all of the caves near my base so far. There's quite a bit of ravine left. There's just a massive ravine, actually a couple of ravines that sort of interconnect right below my base. But that's such a pain to get around in, and there's like lava overflowing it. And so I'm just sort of running around, exploring, looking for iron. Probably starving to death soon. Oh, hello. This looks interesting. Oh, there's got to be iron in here. See some coal. Aha. It didn't take long at all to find all the iron I needed. Kind of surprised. You know, I just said a second ago that I feel like, you know, I've kind of explored all the caves around my base. No, not even close. Certainly a good amount, though. I've kind of noticed that spawn rates of mobs, it's crazy. Let's see. What are we at? Oh, we're still at 108, 106. That's quite a lot. Who knows? So, I've gathered up all the iron that I needed, and I made all the hoppers, and I think I have the room just about done. It actually took me a minute to do the ceiling. I didn't really have the ceiling planned out at all. But I'm really happy with how it all came out. I think it's a really good looking room. It's functional, it's simple. Yeah, I should mention that I'm gonna be doing a lot of work here still, obviously. And I'm gonna have, like I said before, a possibly a hallway that goes this way. I'm not sure where yet. Somewhere. I thought about making a balcony of some kind here also. Not sure, I'll have to think about it. So, if you're ready for the big reveal. Ta-da! It pretty much follows the theme of the rest of the things that I've built so far in this world. Ah, oh, just looking at it from this direction is fantastic. I put these, you wouldn't really call them support beams, I don't think. More just like separators? I don't know. In fancy houses, they sort of have them in the ceiling sometimes, I guess. It just looks really nice. It adds depth, you know what I mean? Adds sort of like three-dimensional depth. And here it looks pretty good. I messed around with some window designs here, and this is what I ended up with. It's kind of simple and, I don't know, a little dorky, but I think it looks good. I tried it also with light gray glass, like striped, in like different ways, but I ended up wasting so much glass, and I don't have silk touch, so I don't know. That'll be it for now. And I put some glass here. I thought about making the whole thing out of glass, but you know what? I kind of thought it would look interesting if it was open like that, so. And I don't think we have to worry about mobs too much, because this is half slab and... Oh, wait. Okay, so this is a half step down. So my question is, can mobs spawn on half slabs if it's at the same level as a normal block? That's kind of scary. Yeah, lighting in general is going to be sort of tricky. As you can see, I still have torches, and hopefully I won't in the future. I have one lamp here. Oh, in behind there. Yeah, I'm really happy with it. It's almost like, kind of reminds me of like a church. If this was a taller window, it would definitely look like a church. We go up here and pray to our potions. Yeah, as you can see, I have all the ingredients labeled. So 10 different ingredients. And I also put what potion it would make underneath. So blaze powder makes strength, and fermented spider eye weakness, etc. It'll be pretty simple once we actually need a potion. Let's say, oh, we're running in here, we need to make a potion of night vision really quick. Of course, we don't have any yet. It'll take time, of course. And I don't know what to put up here. I don't know, we can't put wither skeleton skulls, that would be crazy. I've only fought one and that was insane, so. Yeah, but I don't know, let me know what you guys think of it, and let me know what you guys, if you have any suggestions, anything I can add or change. I sort of scrapped the bridge idea. I'm not so sure how, I don't know, maybe I'll do it in the future. It's just, I think I'll have to do it at a diagonal angle, and that kind of scares me. I don't know how it's going to turn out. But for now, I'm just going to have spiral stairs that possibly, eventually, will go down here and lead to a path so we can get to our farms. Yeah. I think it looks pretty cool. So, this episode is kind of short, and I know it's been sort of a delay, but I've been trying to play other games and get those series done. I actually just finished Out There Somewhere today, finished the final episode. But then I have sound issues with that, and... Oh, it's always a struggle, but it's fun. It's fun trying to work around those issues and entertaining you guys, and I appreciate the comments. It's so awesome. Every time I get like a new subscriber who says, you know, oh, you make good content, like, ah, that makes me feel so good, and I appreciate it. So, yeah, I'll definitely keep making these episodes in the future, and like I said, I love this game so much. But anyways, guys, I've been rambling. So, yeah, I appreciate it. I love you all so much. Thank you for everything, the comments and all that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.